Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So for today's video, I figured I would show you guys how I style my short bob. I am gonna show you how I style it with the straightener. And before we get into that, let me show you a few products I used to kind of prepare my hair before I put heat onto it. So right after I get out of the shower, I usually go for this soy leave-in. It's by Big and Sexy. I love this stuff. It really helps moisturize your hair, keep it feeling healthy. So it's a really good leave-in to use. I also like to mix in a little bit of this Kendra Revive Complex Leave-In. It's like an oil. Also really, really good. This is from the Platinum line. I like to put like 3 pumps of this in my hair, and this actually has heat protection, so it really helps protect my hair from the heat. And I also like to use a little bit of this is BioSilk. This is my favorite stuff ever. It smells so good. I kind of use this as well, just to kind of, you know, I have a lot of like frizz, so this really helps with it. I use it while my hair is wet, and I'm actually going to use a little bit right before we style, just because when you go in with the straightener will kind of like take this oil instead of your natural oil, so to prevent drying out the hair. So I wanted to do this video because I feel like all of the videos that I've seen, like for short bobs, nobody really has that much hair. I would try it and it looked nothing like the video. So I have a ton of hair, as you guys can see. So I'm gonna kind of show you how to kind of work with that. And yeah, so now that I have that prepped, let's get started. So I'm gonna be using this Chi straightener. I think it's a little bit bigger than an inch wide. But I really like using this one to curl my hair. This is my go-to. It heats up pretty quickly. It has like the temperatures here. It does go all the way up to, I think like 3 something. It's heating up right now, but it'll beep when it lets you know that it's ready. So for now, I'm just gonna section my hair because not a lot of hair. So I'm gonna start sectioning off right above the ear. I'm just gonna take the rest of this out of the way. So I don't know if you guys heard it beeping, but it's ready. Oh, I don't know what's going on here. Let me try this again. All right. Oh, and please excuse my no makeup face. I was actually gonna get ready for bed, but I figured I would just quickly hop on and show you guys. So it is all the way up now. It is at 350. I don't want to use that much heat. I'm gonna lower it down to 320. All right, so it's dropping. So the very bottom section of my hair, I usually never like curl it. What I like to do, since I do have a lot of hair, I like to smooth out the very root and the ends, because the ends really tend to flip up, and I like to just kind of twist this away from my face, kind of let that land there. And for the rest of my hair, I'm just gonna flat iron the very tops of the root, just to make it look longer than it really is, because it really helps elongate the hair. So I'm just gonna go all the way around, really, really smooth that out. And for the very front piece, it's the only piece I actually curl in the bottom section. So I do the bottom, and then I just kind of wave this. I don't think this one really waves, so I'm just gonna. So there we go. And then I like to go back. The reason I flat iron my ends is because my hair likes tent, as you guys can see, it like flips up. Like it just likes to flip up, and that takes away from my hair looking longer. So I just literally run the straightener right through the ends just to make it look a little bit nicer. Kind of just do that all the way around. So once that's kind of settled down, my straightener was gonna fall. So it's literally all I do. I just curl these 2 front pieces, and that's about it for this section. So then I'm just gonna take down, really. All right, so I'm gonna take down another section. I do probably about, I do quite a bit of sections because, like I said, I have a lot of hair and I don't feel like I have control over it if I don't section it this much. So honestly, for this, I'm going to do the same, but this, I'm actually going to curl all of it. So again, I'm just going to smooth out the top, make sure the ends are nice and straight, and I'm just going to turn my curling iron. Oh wait, straightener. Whoa. Just to kind of get, you guys can see. Sorry, I don't have a mirror directly in front of me, but I'm just gonna continue doing this basically all the way around the head. Obviously, the more you turn, the more of a curl you get. So, I mean, I'm gonna sleep on this. So I kind of want to curl it a little bit more so it doesn't look like my hair's just straightened tomorrow. My hair does tend to hold a pretty good curl, but I still like to, you know, make sure there's a little bit of a curl. So again, just top, bottom, and then just curl. I've tried to use my curling iron this way, and I mean my straightener this way, and it just doesn't work for me, guys. I wish it did. I don't know what's going on here. It's a little crazy. So I'm gonna work my way from the back to the front. Just quickly. Like, I honestly wish I had less hair. I have so much hair. Like, the amount that I have pinned up is probably what normal people have, and I still have like 10 other sections, so it's like, it's kind of frustrating at times because obviously it takes me a little bit longer to really style it and all that, but I kind of like it because since I do have a lot of hair, I get more of that body in it without really trying, because my hair is just obviously naturally big. I'm just gonna, as you can see, it's not super curly, it's just, then you could see how straightening the ends, I don't know what's going on with that piece, I'm about to straighten that. It's the under, so I'm just literally gonna, but straightening the ends just really helps it make it look loose and beachy and wavy and all that fun stuff. So I'm gonna take one more section this way, and I'm gonna leave this. Worry about parting and all that. So for the section again, nothing different. We're literally just gonna do the same thing. So it's weird because I used to only know how to curl my hair with the curling iron, and I remember when I tried with the straightener, it was the biggest like fail of my life. I couldn't figure it out. It wouldn't work for me, and now I'm so used to the straightener that I tried to use a curling iron the other day, and yeah, let me tell you, did not end up so well. So now this is kind of my go-to fringe. I like the look of it because, like I said, I have really frizzy hair, so it's really hard for me to smooth out my hair with the curling iron for some reason, and the straightener I can do all in one. I actually even used to, when I used to use a curling iron, I would still get my straightener, smooth out the top, bottom, and then use a curling iron in between, which was like a total waste of my time because nobody got time for that, you know? So I'm just gonna make sure I have all the hair. And just keep going. I've actually gotten a lot faster at doing this. It used to take me a really long time because I used to try to make it look so perfect, but honestly, the messier, the better. And I like to make sure I keep all of my curls away from my face. I know a lot of people tend to do some towards the face. I've tried it, and it did not work out for me. So this is what works for me. But, I mean, I would try and stick to whatever you feel works for you. So let me just show you the section. Still just very... very loose. You guys can see like how much body I already have in the hair. So for the last part, my hair, no matter where I section it, it's gonna part wherever I want it. Like even if I curl them down the middle, I can still flip swap them, whatever. I'm just gonna go ahead and do them down the middle today. So I'm gonna take this section out. I'm gonna part this one in two. And then same thing. For these, I really like to make sure they're really smooth just because this is the top layer of my hair. So it's what everyone's really gonna see. And then I'm gonna do one more. Gosh, my hair, my roots are so big. So again, honestly, like there is no, I don't feel like I have some secret, like I overdirect anything any which way. It's just, I feel like this is pretty simple. So I feel like this could really work for a lot of people. I know loose waves are such a thing right now. So as you guys can see, I'm just gonna kind of leave it there. Let that cool down while I work on this side. Let me part. Gosh, so much air. That was a little bit thicker. I think I'm gonna break this side into three. But these sections, I just switch into two. And this one, I don't know how I curl. This is how I curl this side for some reason. I feel like it gives me a lot more body too. Just, break it up into two more that way, because sometimes when I do really big sections my hair gets super puffy because I don't smooth it out as good. So I really like to make sure everything is smooth out. Smoothed. I didn't even say that word. I don't know. And last section, split that into two. Make sure you straighten the ends. Smooth, smooth, and then just smooth. So now that I'm done, I'm just gonna kinda, this is what they're looking like right now. I'm just gonna kinda let them cool down before I kinda mess with them. And then for now, I'll kinda show you. This is what I'm gonna use. This is dry wax, big and sexy. I love this stuff. It smells so good and it gives your hair so much texture. So if you really want that loose, big, messy waves, that is gonna be your best friend. I love it. The second I was introduced to that, I fell in love. So I would highly, highly, highly recommend it. And then I'll also use a little bit more oil in my hair. Just because I get so many frizzies, I think as a girl we all do. But now that they're kind of cooled down, I'm just gonna kind of flip my head and then just kind of like scrunch them and piece them so they're not super curly. And then kind of shake them out. As you could see, like body starts to really form. I used to like flat hair, and now I'm like, the bigger, the better. So just really, really. And then I am gonna take my dry wax. I'm just gonna flip all of the hair to one side, and I'm gonna lift it and just kind of start spraying. Take the other side, kind of do the same. And then just, now that I have that in, like that gives a ton of texture and body. And yeah, that is how I get my big, loose, beachy waves. And then, yeah, just kind of show you guys the back. And then, like I said, see, now my curls kind of let me go whichever way I want. I switch sides because I get a lot more body depending on what side I use. I've been really wearing it to this side, so right now I'm getting a lot of body using this side because it's not used to being on this side. But yeah, well, that is it for this video. I really hope you guys enjoyed it. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye, guys.